security of ASP.NET MVC series. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how can we get input for two classes on a single view and save it to the database. So far, we have not tried anything like this, like where we can get input for more than one classes or more than one tables on a single view and save it to database. So for that reason, I have made a class already, that is student class and user class, and now we want to achieve something like this. Like here we want to provide our students a functionality or a facility to not only give their personal information on a page, and also they are provided the functionality to choose their desired username and password and register to their not only account, and they can pass their information as well. So let's say our business requirement is such that we want our students to provide their personal detail and their user account detail on a single page. So for that, we will be adding these four properties on a single view, where we are getting the values for student table, and here we are getting the values for user table. So when we click register, it must register, and client side validation may also fire. If name is required, there must be validation error here, and if username cannot be less than 5 characters, so the error must be showing up under here. That is client side validation. So because we do not have any method to scaffold two classes at a time, so we have to use the view models. So I have already done one example in my previous videos where we were using the reset and confirm password field, and if you have not watched that video, I will highly recommend to go back and watch that video as well. So if you have not watched it, you can altogether leave it and you can watch this video for proceeding. So let me quickly move to Visual Studio. I have already added a view model to create a view something like this. So I show you that class, like I added a class under view models folder. I named it as register student view model. You can name it whatever name you like, but it is a good convention to end the view model class's name with VM, and I named it as register student view model. And in here I just wrote these properties, guys. Because I know that I have these properties in student class, so on the front end, like here, I just need to use these properties. I want to get user student name, mobile, registration number and GPA for the student class. Like here I want to just get his name, mobile, registration number and GPA. Foreign key and these things are handled programmatically. We do not need to take these things from the user. So and the ID is also auto incremented in the database, so we do not need to get this property defined in the view model class or on the interface. So that is why I just took these four properties from student class, and these two properties, username and password, is to be required via the user class. I need username, I need password. I just commented this over here. This will fire an error in future, so that is why I just commented it over here. So we have these two properties to be listed to the front end, this one more thing, that is confirm password, because student is going to create his account for the first time, so password might be wrong. So unintentionally he or me may pass some password unintentionally wrong. So we need to add one more field, that is confirm password. So I have also added this confirm password field in this view as well. Now I have changed the display text of registration number to registration space number, and I have made the username required and its minimum length must be of 5 characters, as well as I have made a password required and its minimum length is also 5 characters, and I have used this confirm password field, and display name for it is confirm space password, and I want to compare this password field with this. I want to compare this password field with this field, this password field, this one. So next step is to add a controller action method, and after that we add a view for that. So we know that we want to get these values on the interface, and when we click hit enter, we want to post these values to some action method and save the student and user information in the database. So for that we need to add one get and post method. So I have already added this method, so I named this action method as register student, and I have added a view. And if you do not know how to add a view, you go to add view, you let the view name as it is, and you choose the create template, and because we want to create a student and a user, and you choose the model class here as register student view model, so that we can get something like this, like we want to get a view for creation where we have these things, these kind of things. So that is why we need to choose the register student view model class. Now I have already told you that view model classes are not database classes or not mapped to database, so we do not pass here the data context class, okay. And then we hit add, and our view will be added, because I have already added the view, so I cancel this here, okay guys. Now if I go to the view for this register student view model, I can show you that this kind of HTML will be generated, okay. So I just updated the HTML, this text over here, and the rest of the things are same, but I have used here btn primary class to show the button something like this instead of default button. So all the rest of the things are the same. So you can see now here that first form group is used to get student name, next one is for mobile, next is registration number, then GPA, then username, then password, and then confirm password. So that is how we can get input for two classes or two database classes on a single view. In other hand, we can now post these values to a single action method, and we can then separate them accordingly and save it to database. So now when we accept register student view model object, because this view is of register student view model. Now we know that this object has got student class information and user as well. So here what we do, we first want to register a user, and when user is created, we want to add a student to the database, and we pass the information, like I go one by one here from here. this new user dot username is equal to posted object dot username that that the user will write over here, and then u dot password is equal to posted object dot password, and then we are going to save the changes to the database. And now we know that user ID is now generated, that is user primary key. Now we can add the student. So we made a new object for student, and then we named the s dot student dot student name is equal to posted object dot student name, that is this field value, and so on. So things like that goes on, and this foreign key is being applied now, that is student dot user ID, that is foreign key, is being assigned to this via this object, because this object now have got the primary key. So we make it as foreign key over here, and then we add the student to the database and save the changes, and then we redirect to the action of this controller, which is all users, which is listing all the existing users. So let me quickly run it and show you how it's working. So to go to the account slash register account, and we came here and we pass, let me register it like here. Now we can see that GPA field is required, username is required, password field is required, and other fields are not required. It's up to you wherever you pass the required or length attributes, you will see client side validation here, otherwise you will not. So I quickly add some information here, like I add here some registration number here like SPU987, anything, and I pass some GPA here, and I pass the username here as Shahid and password as admin. Now if I pass wrong password here, it will say that confirm password and password do not match. If I correct it back, it says that it's okay. Now we can register this student. Now we know that these values will be posted to the post action method of register student, and from there it will be assigning the values one by one to the user object, and it will create a user, then it will make a object of student, and it will assign values of posted object one by one, and then it will create a foreign key via this object, and it will save it to the database, and it will redirect to this index section method, and it's still running. Let's wait a while. Now it's added. Now you can see that this is Shahid we have just created, and its password is admin. Now to prove whether this data is added to the student table, we go to the student index to verify whether the student is created or not. So now you can see a student with this mobile number, this registration number has successfully been created. Okay guys, this is that much simple to get values for two different tables on a single view using view models and save it to the database. Now you can I run the project by pressing Control F5, but you can breakpoint here, and you can run it by pressing F5 or the play button here, and you can go from here step by step, line by line, and you can view the variable values and things like that. So that's it guys, this was how we can get the input for more than two classes or tables on a single view, and how can we get them reflected to the database. So if tomorrow you want to edit some information of student along with user, you will be adding something like this, and you can post them, and instead of using this query db.users.add, you can use the update query like db.entry.state is equal to entry state dot modified, and you can save the changes. So that's it guys for this tutorial. Stay tuned. Have a great day.